Is this the young kid on the block? Will he be dazzled by Eubank?
Will Eubank try any psychological warfare with him now that they're in the ring?
Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing gold trimmed with red and weighing in at 11 stone, 13 and 3 quarter pounds. In his professional career, he has 45 victories, 23 by knockout with only 2 losses and 2 draws. Plus, he has captured 2 world titles. Ladies and gentlemen, from Brighton, England, here is the former middleweight, the former super middleweight champion of the world, simply the best, Chris his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trimmed with red letters. His weight, 11 stone, 13 and 1 quarter pounds. In his professional career, he has a perfect record of 22 victories without a defeat, 21 by knockout, including 10 KOs in the very first round. Ladies and gentlemen, from Newbridge in Wales, presenting the number one ranked WBO super middleweight in the world,
support for Calzaghe. A lot of flags with the Welsh dragon on. Bids to become only the 8th world champion from Wales.
Know the rules in the dressing room. I expect a good, clean fight. Give me good sportsmanlike conduct. Be my commands at all time. Shake hands. Good luck.
Joe Cortez, who was the referee when Lennox Lewis did his 95-second job on Andrew Gallotta in Atlantic City a week ago, has flown the Atlantic to be here. Fight number 50 for Chris Eubank. But is this a comeback born of desperation for money and a craving for limelight? Or has Eubank rediscovered a genuine desire to restate his credentials? And what about Calzaghe? Untried. And let's go with the left hand straight away. Eubank may... I don't know whether he might just try to catch Calzaghe cold.
Well, Calzaghe is a very fast starter. 10 first round.
Oh, the left hand! Puts Eubank on the floor for only the 5th time in his career. What a start by Calzaghe. He means business, all right, this Welshman. Eubank is smiling. He was only down for about 2, but had to take a mandatory 8. What a start.
I said 10 first round wins, no chance of him being caught a little bit cold. A beautiful punch from Joe Calzaghe and a wonderful start.
Well, if he was suffering from any butterflies, he won't be now. He does have to watch Eubank on the counter, though, as Eubank has proved more than once that he's dangerous as a counter-puncher. I think Eubank actually mouthed to Calzaghe across the ring, good shot. And there's another, Calzaghe left. This is the reality for Eubank now of his comeback. Forget the theme tunes and the posturing. Calzaghe's been telling us for a long time that he is a real factor in this super middleweight equation. A lot of people, quite good judges, have said they don't think he can really fight, that he slaps, that he's an arm puncher.
Well, I think he should with that punch. He's certainly not an arm puncher, and I think his 21 knockouts and 22 fights suggest he isn't.
Remember, Eubank has never been stopped, but Calzaghe is working him over in this first round. Eubank is in some trouble here. He may need all his resilience and solid chin to get through this, and Calzaghe is setting a pace that Eubank does not like, and these punches, head and body, are thudding home.
What a terrific start from Joe Calzaghe, letting every punch in the book go.
It's a really exciting start from Calzaghe. Who said that he might suffer stage fright? Forget that. Eubank somehow has to weather this. like he's even moving through the shoppers now. He's loving the big stage. Head, body shots. I've always had the suspicion with this fellow that he's very heavy-handed. I watched him in the gym one day at work, and you just had that impression. Oh, what a start by Calzaghe. Eubank has got through it. He's trying to look cool and composed. But goodness me, he took a bit of a shellacking.
He really did. And difficult to look cool and composed when you've had to take the first round like that. A little nod there of appreciation, I think. He certainly took a good shot. A left hand flush on the chin, just as he was moving backwards. And he goes down on the seat of his pants. He was up quickly. He's always had a terrific chin, Chris Eubank. But that was a good shot and a beautiful start from Joe Calzaghe.
Well, these fights are always so interesting, these cross-generation fights. The old champion, be the hot prospect, experience against youthful ambition, guile against raw power. Well, Eubank is going to have to show some real grit and championship quality to come back from that first round and become a world champion again. And this is his first fight in England for over 2 years. Calzaghe with Peyton reach advantages as well, as being 6 years younger. Eubank. Remember, Eubank can hit. Does have some power, or always did. Again, another big left from Calzaghe.
It's a good punch, Ian. He's catching Eubank with that one every time.
Remember, too, until about 11 days ago, Calzaghe thought he was working towards Steve Collins, not Eubank, so he's had to switch the strategy in his head. Different kind of fighters. Can Eubank find any way into this argument? Still early.
But Calzaghe's not missing with many. The right jab's good from the southpaw stance, but the left hook is especially good.
Super confident Calzaghe, trained by his father Enzo, who will be proud of what he's done so far, but the job is not complete by any means. All we've seen so far is a good start, and there's more to winning world championships than that.
But he's certainly, I think, the best point from Calzaghe is he's fighting his fight at his pace. He's not falling down to Eubank's pace, which a lot of fighters do. Certainly Steve Collins didn't do, and that's why he had two very good wins. And really, that's what Calzaghe has got to fight at his own pace.
Eubank's comeback could stall right here if he doesn't get past Calzaghe. Again, clubbed by those left hands. They were slapping left hands, really, those from Calzaghe. Landed with the inside of the glove. Technically shouldn't count, but they probably did with the judges. Now, Joe Cortez has to separate them at the end of the round. Now, Eubank's going walkabout, as if to say, well, I might have been caught by some shots, but I'm okay. Is he?
Well, he does that really just to take the eye away from his opponent or the judges, but I think he has been caught by good shots, and he's got to conserve his energy. There's still this worry about the weight.
Yes, that's right. Remember that up to 2 weeks ago, Eubank was supposed to be fighting Mark Prince at light heavyweight, Then, with Steve Collins' retirement, he was ushered into this at super middleweight. Now, that's a 7-pound difference. But he's made it okay, and he was 12 stone 2 a week ago, so the board of control are happy. Calzaghe's landed 41 to 18 so far in his favour. Third round at this packed Sheffield Arena. This is some night of sport, isn't it? One way and another. Are we in here on the birth of a new star in Joe Calzaghe? Or will Eubank, as he's done so often in the past, find a way to prevail? I suppose in Eubank's favour, at least he's got through the opening blitz.
Yes, he got through that, but surely Calzaghe's going to have to settle down a little bit, just get his boxing together and then start to pick it up again. And he's got to keep switching the pace a little bit, Calzaghe.
Use that left hand again. Four or five of them to head and body from the youngster.
Eubank trying the overhand right, but it's quite a slow punch and Calzaghe can see it coming.
Have to ask how much those two defeats by Steve Collins have taken away from Eubank. Oh, again a big left from Calzaghe, forcing Eubank back. He needs that solid chin in here.
Work his body, work his body, man. Bust his body up. That's it. And again, bust his body out.
Again, Eubank has to give ground as the left hand gets through. Got him with his own good uppercut there, though.
Again, the left hand landed from Calzaghe. He's working well, Calzaghe, pushing him forward.
Some nice uppercuts, and Eubank starting to get in with some good-looking body shots as well. He's trying to slow Calzaghe down a little. Maybe just reel him in. Calzaghe really is like a young lion, full of hunger and ambition.
Again, that wild right hand from Eubank, missing wildly with that.
Countering left, this time from Calzaghe. As the bell goes to end the third round, Eubank did better in that third round. Is he finding some kind of foothold?
Calzaghe still doing good, he's still keeping himself composed and still looking for that left hook. But Eubank just started to land a little better with some good punches inside and especially to the body.
Calzaghe, who was 13 when Eubank made his professional debut, used to watch Eubank on the television. Here he is in the ring with him. Eubank, you can see his ploy, body punches where he can. Mike Calzaghe's inexperience catch up with him, as he has to maybe dig a little deeper than ever before in a longer and more grueling fight. Most of his opponents so far have been on the soft side, I think it's fair to say, though he did have a decent win over Mark Delaney, Steve Wilson, in a British title fight.
Yes, but it's still it's a big step up to this kind of class.
Absolutely.
And he's got to keep a high work rate, Calzaghe. He can't allow Eubank to start getting into his stride.
Eubank down in the opening seconds for only the fifth time in his life. Oh, left hand again. Big shot, Calzaghe. Eubank took it well. Left himself a bit open, though. Again, fast hands from Calzaghe, who just brings naked aggression and obviously some power to the show here. He wants this championship really badly. How deep can Eubank dig?
And Calzaghe putting the pressure on Eubank.
Calzaghe's re-established himself in this fourth round, and he's beginning to club Eubank around with ominous regularity. That's a great right, though, by Eubank. Still dangerous.
Calzaghe looks much better when he puts his punches together in clusters, has good success, and Eubank just can't handle that sort of pace.
This is a busier Eubank. He knows he can't posture here. Calzaghe isn't going to allow him to do that. He said that at the pre-fight press conferences. I'm not going to let him pose. I'll be at him all the time. Calzaghe says, I'm younger, I'm stronger, I'm fitter than Calzaghe, than Eubank.
He's forever the showman. You know, even if it's getting hard, even if he's getting beat as on points, I haven't at this point. You know, he's still got to play to the crowd. He's still got to have that little bit of time for a little bit of showmanship. That's made him the character he is.
It's also for the judges' benefit as well, isn't it?
Well, I think it is. It's to take the eye away, to make him look fresh and to make it look as if, you know, he's had a good round. But I think the judges are probably saying something a little bit different. Calzaghe's still doing very well. Just picked up the pace again in this round and just did a little bit more than Eubank.
It was Calzaghe's round, despite Eubank's decent finish. Here's the fifth round. Eubank, former champion at middle and super middleweight, looks to regain the title, left open by Steve Collins' retirement. Calzaghe won't give Eubank a second.
That's how I've got it with Calzaghe in a four-point lead, making such a good start in that 10-8 round in the first.
Good left hand from Eubank. Calzaghe's chin is passing the test, isn't it? Here, some wondered about that because we've never seen him put under pressure before.
Well, he's had to take some good punches inside. Eubank's uppercut is working well, but Calzaghe's took it well.
The only time Calzaghe was taken the distance was by Eubank's cousin, actually, Bobby Joe Edwards. And Calzaghe was giving lumps of weight away to him.
As Edwards a cruiserweight, that's two weights up from Calzaghe, so that's a lot of weight to give away, but he won very easily. Well, it's hotting up the action in centre ring.
And Calzaghe's the one who, for my money, is getting the better of it. He's the one who's forcing Eubank backwards. There is a real intensity and desire about Calzaghe here. Can he sustain it? He may have to go the full 12-round route against this fellow. Back came Eubank with a very good countering right and a right uppercut. Now it's a trade-off. Eubank fought his way off those ropes well. He is dangerous with his back to the ropes like that.
Yes, he is, but he's, Calzaghe, setting such a terrific pace. And he caught Eubank several times.
Oh, big left and a right. And Eubank, how did he stay up from those? Two-punch combination. Eubank was staggered. But he seems to have this capacity for his head to clear almost instantly.
He looks a little bit hurt, Eubank. The legs are just starting to betray him, looking a little heavy.
Wants to hold on by a bit of time, but goodness me, didn't Eubank show some resilience there? He's breathing heavily, though, Eubank. This is hard for Eubank now. He's going to have to come from a long way off the pace if he wants this to be a glory night for him.
Eubank's battling back very hard indeed, but he's had to. Joe Calzaghe is really fighting out of his skin and answering a lot of questions. He really is showing good heart, good spirit, and he does have that very strong punch.
He's just all over Eubank. He's so eager. I think Eubank's probably been made to work harder here than he's done for many of his fights. Obviously, Steve Collins was at him like this as well, wasn't he? But
that's right. And I think, obviously, Calzaghe has watched the tapes and seen how to fight Eubanks. And that's really just to set a very high pace, as Steve Collins did so well.
And it's
and
an easy...
he's doing it.
It's an easy strategy for him to affect. It's his natural style, really.
That's right. And also, he's strong, and you wonder how much... You know, how he's going to struggle, Eubank, with the weight. Look at these punches he's taking. I mean, really, he stood up to some terrific punches there.
So here we go with round six. Eubank has decided to put on a spurt to do something about that, but left himself open. Calzaghe is clever there. He kept his gloves up, waited for an opening, and Eubank has had to call off the assault. I tell you, at the moment, the young man is the boss in there.
Eubank came out to try and take the play away from Calzaghe there, but Calzaghe was ready to meet him and give him more.
Left hand and a right uppercut from Eubank. He'll be waiting and watching for signs of wear and tear in Calzaghe too. It's been a hard fight. It's already been twice as good as most Eubank fights. And he got through that straight right hand too. He's not finished with the end, Eubank, in here, you know. Oh, well, I think he hoodwinked Calzaghe. Then he looked up to the ring lights, then hit him with a right uppercut. Calzaghe takes that too.
What a fight this is turning out to
superb,
be.
Superb, isn't it?
The youth against the experience.
These two are providing us with a thriller. Oh, straight left hand. Terrific shot from Calzaghe, and again, Eubank absorbed it like a slice of blotting paper.
It looked as if that took a fair bit out of Eubank. The legs again became heavy, stiffened to the canvas. Heavy shots from Joe Calzaghe.
He's breathing heavily, Eubank. He's waving Calzaghe in. He wants to counter him. And look at Eubank's hand speed still. I tell you what, Eubank himself has shown he still has the desire to carry on as a fighter.
Yes, he really has. This is a very hard fight. Zaki's ahead and looking to hit the heart and looking well, but Eubank's still there and still looks as if he can be a constant threat.
And there still may be a twist in this. Remember, Calzaghe's stamina is an unknown quantity. Eubanks isn't. Oh, a big left hand again from Calzaghe in that exchange. Oh, and a right hand and another left hook. Eubank is having to take a lot. And still he punches the air. Well, the crowd are on their feet at this, including Richard Branson, I can see, on the far side. Celebrities sprinkled around the place, of course.
Well, I think they're all applauding the courage of Eubank, who's took some heavy shots and come back And this is a terrific fight, centre ring, really going at it. Eubank giving as good as he was getting there, coming back so well. And there's still a fair bit of fire in Eubank's belly.
There really is. I mean, people forget with him, he's often criticised for being lazy and posturing in his fights, and that is true, but he also came through earlier on in his career some intense wars, notably the first fight with Ben, you know, beating Rocky Gianni in Berlin, the two Michael Watson fights.
Well, I think Calzaghe's bringing some of that fire back, and Calzaghe is making him fight, because if Eubank doesn't, he's going to get beat here.
Here's round seven. Eubank again goes for the fast start. Can he break Calzaghe's resistance? Well, it's a punch-for-punch trade-off.
On the far side of the ring, Herbie Hyde on his feet, Nazim Hamed on his feet. Really enjoying this fight.
Well, they're going to talk about this one for some time, whatever happens. We have a real battle of wills. If Eubank can win this, after everything that's happened, you'd probably have to put it down as his biggest win since the day he became WBO middleweight champion against Nigel Benn in that Birmingham Classic back in 1990. But that's a big if. Whose will break first here? Calzaghe is well ahead, but Eubank's spirit is far from broken, you sense.
Calzaghe a little quieter in this round. He's fought at such a pace, he's got to be starting to tire.
Respect for each other already, I would think. Calzaghe has already answered a lot of questions, but he hasn't answered the ultimate question, which is, can he win and beat somebody like Eubank?
Calzaghe a little tired in this round. He's looking to hold on a little bit more. This is his quietest round.
Just both on the floor, there's no knockdown there that I could see anyway, and Joe Cortez sees it the same way. Well, if Eubank is tight at the weight, you could have fooled me.
Certainly could. He's fought at such a pace and he's took such heavy punches,
and that's a tribute to how hard he's worked for this. Oh, big right from Eubank on the foul, and I think he would have taken that round. Is he on the way back? Eighth round. Little bit of damage around the eyes of Calzaghe. Hint of swelling. Nothing much at the moment. They both look remarkably unblemished for the kind of contest it's been. These are good body shots from Eubank, who wants to go to war again. But Calzaghe will not be dominated.
Good fast combination from Calzaghe with Eubank's back on the ropes, just to tell him he's the boss, or at least he's trying to be the boss.
It's a thrilling fight. Another right hand. I think that one stunned Eubank momentarily.
Yes, his head just dropped down at that point. And I've got it there, Calzaghe. He might win the last round, but Calzaghe's still in a big lead.
And there's no sign of Calzaghe's tank running dry yet. Eubank will be hoping beyond hope that it might do. It's a fascinating one, this.
And Eubank telling Nazim to shut up there. I think Nazim is having a few comments to Eubank, and Eubank just told him to shut up.
Breathing a bit heavily, Eubank, his arms down by his side. Surely can't carry on at this ferocious pace.
Well, it's been a terrific fight, and the crowd absolutely riveted.
Just getting a bit ragged. But you can forgive them that in a fight like this. Good body shots from Eubank. Two or three.
One in there straight, a little bit low.
He's found some good uppercuts, Eubank, as well. But Calzaghe is still winging away with these sweeping left hooks of his.
Calzaghe answered a lot of questions about his heart, his chin, his determination.
And his right to be here.
Exactly.
Now this division is just bursting with great fights, and let's hope we see them. Just a hint of a slap again. Does that sometimes, Calzaghe? It's with the inside of the glove. Well, that was another good round, but in this fight it was a quiet one. Now let's take a look at Calzaghe in there. Are there any signs of tiredness at all? Look at the number of punches Calzaghe has thrown. 400 punches so far in 8 rounds. Almost, well, getting on, isn't it, for double the Eubank tally.
Yes, he keeps letting them arms pump away. This is early in the round. He gets Eubank with his back up against the ropes, and he starts to let them go. Eubank getting his hands up and taking most of them on the gloves.
Yeah, not many of them landed, did they?
They didn't. And I think that showed in the computer. There wasn't that great a success rate for Calzaghe, although he's still winning the rounds, and although I give that round a level, but he's still ahead on points.
This is new ground for Joe Calzaghe. Never been this far before. Will he last home? He does his training on the very steep hills around his home in Newbridge, South Wales. He says, my training runs are not like other fighters. I run uphill quick. He may need all that conditioning here. You give Eubank enormous credit here, don't you? Because he's tried to match Calzaghe's fire with plenty of his own. And, you know, against many, many people, this level of performance would have been good enough for a big win for him tonight.
That's right, he really has. At the beginning of the rounds, he's trying to catch Ujjudge's eye by coming out, really taking the fight to Calzaghe. He's trying to give as good as he's got. Calzaghe just getting through with more punches. But Eubank fighting a good fight. Still a lot left.
Watch the rabbit punches, says the referee to the eager Calzaghe.
And you wouldn't have thought Eubank would still be here fighting like this after you saw him go down so heavily in the first round.
Right hand from Calzaghe was an eye catcher. Clubbing Eubank around. Both of them must be tiring after a fight of this intensity.
But still, both of them throwing punches. Eubank looking to try and bring them up, but Calzaghe just throwing more. Calzaghe looks as if he's getting a second win, just picked up the pace a little bit more in this round.
Doing most of the work. There's a bit of a swelling underneath his right eye. They had the ice on that between the rounds. It's nothing much, though. Still, Eubank pumping in these body shots when he can, hoping to stop and tire this younger man. Well, if Calzaghe wins this, he's going to be a hero back in Wales, where they revere their world champions, men like Jim Driscoll and Jimmy Wilde and Howard Winston.
Calzaghe landed a good left hand there. It's a good exchange from him.
Look at Eubank come back at him, letting go with right hands. Had to give ground again. He just cannot put out Calzaghe's fire, though.
Again, he was hurt by another shot from Calzaghe. Good round for Calzaghe.
Crowd here absolutely enraptured by this, as they were earlier on watching the other fights. Calzaghe with a left-hand counter, and Eubank touched down with his gloves. That has to be a knockdown. He's saying, I slipped. I don't think so. It was a left hand. He's not hurt by it, but technically, his gloves touched the canvas, and that has to go down as a knockdown.
There was a sharp little punch in there. The quick reflexes of Joe Calzaghe just caught Eubank lunging in. He had to touch down with both his hands.
And the way they score these things, that may cost him extra points as well. Eubank's talking to Calzaghe.
I'm sure he'll be worried about that, Eubank.
Of course, in the past, Eubank has, well, how can I put it, had a few favours, it seems, from the judges. But this is a different setup. Can Calzaghe keep this going?
Well, I must say I'm impressed with Calzaghe. In the past, he's never really shown me that he's a mature fighter. He's got the job done that quickly. We haven't really seen what he's got, but in this fight, he's showing he's got a great deal of talent.
This is the fight I think he wanted. He wanted to prove to the world that he can operate at this level. He's looked exciting, too, doing it here. And that is, of course, going to make him a bit of a seller. Robin Reid, the WBC champion, is watching this, and I'm sure he's working out a few things about strategies and styles for if he should be meeting Calzaghe somewhere down the road. I know he is. Fighters do. But this argument isn't settled yet. Enzo, Calzaghe's dad, in the corner, his trainer shouting out to him, saying, don't get idle. Enzo, who was brought up in the same village as Gianfranco Zola in Sardinia.
Credit to Enzo. I think people have wondered whether a father and son relationship works, but certainly it's working with this father and son, because he's prepared his son tremendously well for this contest.
Yes, if it is a Calzaghe triumph, it will be a family triumph. Quiet around. Eubank's got a lot of work to do. In fact, I would venture to suggest he needs a knockout.
Yes, I certainly think he does. I've got him a long way behind. He's fighting tremendously well, but for me, Calzaghe's, there's the punch that put him down. Just a short little one, but he was coming forward under the punch, and it was a good little sharp punch, and he did touch down with both hands.
All right, seconds out. Seconds out. Round 11.
6 minutes left. 6 minutes for Eubank to rescue it. Otherwise, it looks like Calzaghe's night. But we've seen Eubank turn things around before. One doesn't like to really raise the subject as Glenn's scorecard, but do you remember the 11th round of the terrible and tragic fight, second fight with Michael Watson? But what happened in the ring there was that Eubank turned things around when he was facing defeat. And that's what's relevant maybe in this equation.
Well, I think he's still got a fighter's heart, but remember, he's a good deal older now, and he's been through a lot more fights, and his career is much farther advanced. So whether he can pull something out at this stage, you know, we're yet to see.
Still, Calzaghe taking the fight to Eubank. Funnily enough, Eubank's old trainer, Ronnie Davis, who was with him 9 years, predicted that Calzaghe would win. He said he'd be too fast and powerful for Eubank. Interesting.
Well, that's proving right. But it must have been hard to come down a weight. But Calzaghe, you can't take nothing away from Calzaghe. He's really shown to be a mature and a very good fighter.
It looks as if he's going to turn himself from being regarded as a talented prospect with a few question marks about him to somebody we have to take pretty seriously. He's up now in the big money league, Calzaghe, if he can hold on to this. Eubank may be saving himself for one last desperate rally.
Eubank's lunging, he's looking for the big punch, just dropping his head a little bit inside there. I'm sure he's very, very tired.
Calzaghe has hit him with so many big punches. Eubank has got through with plenty of his own here. He's hoped that somewhere along the line Calzaghe would snap, but it hasn't happened, and it's getting late.
This has been a much quieter round, not a great deal happening. Maybe Eubank's trying to suck it all in this round for a
no knockdown. No knockdown, just his momentum took him there. Breathing heavily, just moving a little unsteadily on his legs as well now, Eubank. He's kind of shuffling around the ring.
As he's looking heavy and looking to fall forward onto Calzaghe. Again, he tries that lunging right hand.
His chin was always one of his great assets, of course. And it's held him in good stead tonight. 3 minutes left.
I think a new talent is certainly emerging on the scene. He's got 3 more minutes to hang out, and I'm sure if he can do that, he's... will be the new world champion.
Chewing an extravagant lifestyle count for nothing here. He's put up a tremendous fight, but Calzaghe, for the most part, has been boss. And Eubank now surely needs a knockout. Last round.
And you can guarantee he knows that, and you can guarantee he's gonna go for it. Calzaghe's still got that bounce in his step, still looks reasonably fresh.
But if he's sensible, Calzaghe, he may just look to box this through and be too cautious, maybe even. Just make sure he gets the victory. Remember Bruno in the last round against Bone Crusher Smith? What was he, 9 rounds ahead or something? Got knocked out in the last. Tried to go for the stoppage. Calzaghe's doing that here.
Yes, it doesn't look as if he's going to try and be cautious. He's fought this fight aggressive on the attack, very confidently, and it looks as if he wants to finish the fight the same way.
Calzaghe has come of age. Still, all the work coming from Calzaghe. Eubank is very tired now, but he may keep his proud record of never having been stopped.
Calzaghe caught by a thumping right hand from Eubank.
His chin's been proved here, Calzaghe. You can put a tick against that in future now.
I think everything's been proved in this fight. He's got a punch, he's got the style, he's got a good chin.
And there's another Eubank right hand. Under a minute remaining. Eubank needing snookers.
Both land with good punches there. Calzaghe with the right, Eubank also with the right hand.
And still they want to trade to the last. This has been a superb fight.
Well, if Eubank's going to go out with this fight, if this will be his finale, he'll go out in style and put up a tremendous battle.
Well, he may not go out after this. He can walk out of this ring with his head held high. Whether he would want to fight on. This has been another aging fight, really. But Calzaghe has answered the questions here. All of them in the affirmative. Calzaghe just stung by one right hand, you felt there, right towards the end. Holds on, there's the final bell. They embrace at the bell, the fusion of spirits. Calzaghe is lifted aloft. I think we all know which way the judges will see that.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecards. Dave Power scores the bell, 118 to 109. Paul Thomas scores it, 116 to 111, and Roy Francis scores it, 118 to 111, for the winner, who is now WBO Super Middleweight Champion of the World, Joe Calzaghe!
What a moment for Joe Calzaghe! A moment he will never, ever forget as long as he lives. Joe Calzaghe, world champion. How does that sound?
Sounds brilliant, you know, all the hard work I've done. I just thank God. Obviously, I thank my dad, I thank my wife. I thank all the fans who come to support me tonight. They give me a lot of incentive. I put him down early in the first round, and in a way, I'm a bit disappointed not to knock him out, you know.
But he's never been stopped in his life. You had him down early. It looked like you might blast him out and really make a name for yourself.
I had the capability to stop him. I knocked him down a couple of times and I hurt him all the time, showed that I have plenty of great punch power, like, because you might never be stopped. Bit of an experience, and they showed they had the fitness and they showed they had the chin, because he caught me some good shots, didn't even battle me at all. And it's only better to come. You know, that's my first meaningful fight, my first 12-round fight, and it beat former champion Chris Eubank easy. You know?
How important was it for you not only to win the world championship, but to do it in such exciting, ticket-selling style like that?
Well, I was, you know, it was good, but it wouldn't have been as good if I knocked him out early, which I should have. But, you know, I'm still really pleased. Taking nothing away from Chris Eubank, he's still got a lot of art, and maybe he's got, you know, he's still got something to give to the game.
Do you feel a bit sorry for him because he put up some fight, didn't he?
No, I don't feel sorry for him at all. At the end of the day, he was in there trying to beat me, and when someone's trying to beat me, you know, I just got to take him out. Simple.